Christopher Lau, the head of the procurement service of the DPM, resigned in June. And then you have the Wendell Avisado, the budget chief, resigns also 6 days ago. And then this blows up in our face. Isn't that a bit, I mean, do you question or do you doubt the resignations of such high officers in the DBM in the midst now of a full-blown investigation on these funds amounting to billions of pesos?
The resignation of the secretary is especially troublesome because, remember, Karen, the 2022 budget has not yet been submitted. And this is, you know, the existence or the principal work of the, the existence of the DBM is only because of the budget. And right now, it has not yet been submitted. The sudden resignation to me is a little unusual. Of course, he said that it was for health reasons. We accept that, but if this health reasons has been there for some time, if they talk about the heart bypass 8 years ago, it's there's too much of this gives rise to a lot of speculation, and now being uncovered is the 42 billion that was moved to the procurement service. The public speculates whether you like it or not, especially with this SCOA report. The public speculates, and given the past incidents where the procurement service was exposed to have been accountable for the overpricing of the face mask and the face shields, which are essential tools to fight the pandemic, then you put 1 + 1, and we do hope to have the answers to these questions when the Blue Ribbon will dig deeper into this issue.
Mm. So is it right to assume that the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee would be calling Christopher Lau and also Wendell Avisado at one point?
Christopher Lau will be called is already done. Senator Gordon said so yesterday. All the documents pertaining to the purchases of the procurement service in relation to the 42 billion is being summoned, and that should be produced. The invitation to Secretary Avisado, I am not aware of, and we assume assume regularity, and therefore that he is sick. He is sick, so we leave it at that. I do not know what Senator Gordon will decide on. Mm-hmm. But as of yesterday, only Christopher Lau was being required to appear before the Blue Ribbon.
Okay, there's a question here. I know that the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee is focusing on the health department, correct? So you will not be calling other agency heads, because the COA also flagged other agency heads on how they spent the budget, but you are focusing on health.
Yes, because the matter of the other agencies will be taken up when we hear their budgets for 2022. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of questions that to be asked. Recently, or in the last 2 days, you hear about OWA, a trust fund, purchasing overpriced sanitary pads. So this will be raised, purchasing it from a non-existing company. Okay. All of this will be raised.
All right. Now, the COA said by flagging deficiencies, it does not prove corruption. Fair. But do the Filipino people, frankly, have to live with poor managers, inefficient, frankly speaking, public officials or people working in government? Do the Filipino people have to live with officials like that? Some said it may not be criminal negligence at this point, but is it malfeasance? Is it, are there other, offenses created, committed that could be brought against inefficiency for government officials?
Well, certainly gross negligence is a ground for disciplinary action under our civil service rules, and a career employee who is negligent can be disciplined anywhere from warning, suspension, to dismissal. But insofar as a cabinet member is concerned, whether or not a cabinet member remains in government is a political decision on the part of the president. Nobody can compel the president to dismiss or to dismiss Secretary Duque, because the continued stay of Secretary Duque in the cabinet is a matter of trust on the part of the president. And the president is answerable to the people if Secretary Duque does not perform his job in accordance with the expectation. That ultimately becomes an issue of the appointing power, the president.
Okay, yeah. Senator Grace Poe already asked yesterday, shouldn't Secretary Duque at this point be suspended by now if she says we're going to apply the same judgment in the PhilHealth executives? The ombudsman issued a resolution in October 2020, and he imposed a six-month preventive suspensions on eight of PhilHealth executives. They were facing a graft complaint for the alleged misappropriation of 2 billion pesos in the IRM funds. Do you agree with Senator Grace Poe that at this point the ombudsman should have already suspended Secretary Duque, or it's too early for that?
Well, Karen, I do not recall of any member of the cabinet being suspended. Okay. What I do recall is that in certain instances or similar events of what transpired, the cabinet member would take a leave in order to allow the investigation to take place. So again, this is addressed to the judgment of the cabinet member, because they are political appointees, and they hold their positions on the trust of the president. And I would repeat, the fate of Secretary Duque is up to the president, except where there are criminal acts committed, in which case the ombudsman would come in. Mm-mm. But at this stage, there is no allegation of corruption.